medication or pain medication to hook me up to my second to last bag of my antibiotics. We were up really, really late last night, me and my roommate talking, and I'm just so grateful that she's awesome, and she's 40 years older than me, but we're really close. But so yeah, breakfast, I guess, sort of came up. I've been stomaching yogurt really well, so I think maybe when I go home, I'll stock up on yogurt, because I'm stomaching it, and I may or may not go home tomorrow, I'm not sure yet. I am almost done with my last Vanco. I'm so excited. And I'm working on some vlog stuff. Yeah, just resting. And my stomach has been handling these pretty well. I'm feeling a bit shaky. And my pulse isn't like really, really high. But we don't know really what's going on. So the, on-call doctor is gonna come see. I have no idea what it is, but it's not like a pot. So I don't know what's going on. So I just had the creepiest doctor come in to check on me. They checked my blood sugar. My blood sugar was fine. Excuse me. And I'm drinking water and I'm hooked up to my continuous fluids. And lips are all messed up. What the heck? What is that? Ew, I'm sorry, guys. They tested my blood sugar. That was fine. And then they did an EKG, but the doctor, you like it was staring at me, and if you've ever had an EKG in your girl, you have to put it like under your left boob, so you kind of flash whoever's around, and he was just kind of like standing and staring. And so the nurse and the PCA like went and took the curtain and closed it. So creepy. So it wasn't blood sugar, but I'm having another yogurt. I don't think that it was the pots, so, but even just in case it was, I have my continuous fluids, I'm drinking water, and then, I took Seroquel, which is an anxiety medication, so, like, any of the three things that it most likely is, I'm covering just to make sure, and I'm just kind of getting all the vlogs up and kind of doing some stuff. Yeah, that is what is up. It's like 12:15, so we'll see how the rest of the night goes. Being here for almost 2 weeks, and you know, it's exciting to go home, but being in the hospital and you're here for an extended period of time, it becomes like a new normal, and you start feeling safe and comfortable, and yeah, like safe here. And adjusting to being home and not being in someone's care 24/7 and just not being in the environment that you were in for a decent amount of time, it's really nerve-wracking and anxiety-inducing. And so I'm excited about going home. I'm excited to go back and be sharing my bed with Adrian. And I'm excited to see all of the animals and having freedom again. But at the same time, I feel so anxious about not being in a place that has kept me very safe recently. And the other night, like last night, I was talking to my roommate about it, and she's like 60, and she brought it up actually. She was saying the same thing. So there's a lot that goes through your mind during like the different stages of being in the hospital. And I'm just at a stage where I want to go home, but I'm also nervous too. And I will miss the nurses and the PCAs. They've been amazing to us, and I'm very appreciative of that. And that was the vlog out. I'll see you guys tomorrow. It's like 1:30.